Hi, and welcome back to A Better You. I'm your host, Cynthia Thompson, and today I have a special guest with me, Jeb Blackwell. Jeb is the city engineer for the city of Charlotte. Thank you for joining us today, Jeb.
My pleasure, Cynthia.
Before we start talking about what exactly you do for the city of Charlotte, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm just had a birthday, November 2nd.
Yeah,
I'm 53. I'm actually a native. I've lived in Mecklenburg County all my life.
Uh-huh.
I was born here. It was Charlotte Memorial Hospital at the time. So now CMC. Went to North Mecklenburg High School.
Uh-huh.
And then came back after college and have lived in this area all my life.
Uh-huh. And what college did you go to?
My first degree was from the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill.
Uh-huh.
And I built houses for a few years. And then I went to North Carolina State and got a degree in engineering. And
so
that's how I came to be an engineer with the city of Charlotte.
So your department is called Engineering and Property Management, and that's a big name, and I'm sure you do a lot of work for the city. From what I understand, you have several different divisions within your department. We have buildings and landscape, building service, business services,
Real estate.
Engineering services. Stormwater. And I think I got them all, didn't I? Land development. I was afraid I was going to miss one, but there's quite a few people. How do you take care of that all by yourself? Surely you don't do all that by yourself.
No, not nearly all by myself.
Uh-huh.
We're really fortunate that there are a lot of really talented people in engineering and property management.
Uh-huh.
And they do most of they do a lot of heavy lifting. And so the good news is that I don't have to know nearly everything that's going on, because we do such a wide array of things that really you can't keep up with everything. You've got to have good people who will get their work done.
But you have a core team that works with you, which consists of your assistant, of course, and then you have...
There are two deputy directors.
Uh-huh.
And then there are division managers over those six work groups that you
uh-huh.
described.
Uh-huh.
And that's where the work happens. One of the things that I always think as a guiding principle is that if you're not directly serving a citizen, you ought to be thinking about what you can do to make it easier for people who do. And
and
in senior management, we don't interact with as many citizens. I do deal with some citizens most
uh-huh.
every week, but our staff does that on a daily basis, and we really put a lot of emphasis on doing that well. And trying to make their job easier is what I need to be doing.
Uh-huh. What I would like for us to do here tonight, Jeb, is to go over what each section does in your department. Let's start with buildings and landscape. What exactly do they do for the entire city of Charlotte?
Well, there's a group that manages the city's buildings,
and there are
about 160 city buildings that they manage, about 4 million square feet of heated area, and those run from the government center to nearly 40 fire stations, police district, and the law enforcement center, some of the utility departments, things, performing arts center, those kinds of things.
Mm-hmm.
We manage a wide array of buildings, and that is everything from setting up conference rooms, to changing light bulbs, to switching out mechanical units, or those
mm-hmm.
sorts of things, new roofs when they need work. We also have, in landscape management, there are about 180,000 street trees that they manage. They mow the city's right-of-ways. The city has six cemeteries.
And we
manage those cemeteries. There's some areas where we have flower beds of Tryon Street and that sort of thing where we do some of those kinds of projects. And they also help with tree planting, and a lot of it is tree removal and tree trimming. And then also within that same group, we build buildings for the city. And so that runs all the way from the Hall of Fame to fire stations to, we just finished the Metro Police Station on Bates Ford Road. So they build a fairly wide array of buildings. During my time with the city, we built two arenas, one at Tyvola Road and one uptown now. And so those are really fun projects. And when you're in engineering school, you hope to get to work on really great projects. And,
that's a dream,
and I've really
huh?
been fortunate to be able to do that. I was a project manager actually on the government center.
Oh, really?
Yeah, over 20 years ago. So
uh-huh.
that's buildings and landscape management.
Uh-huh.
That would be a description kind of what they do. Land development division. They handle the building permitting. When I say building permitting, they don't handle mechanical, electrical, the stuff that's inside the building.
Uh-huh.
The part they handle is the site requirements, drainage, driveways, sidewalks, trees, the zoning requirements such as buffers and that sort of stuff. And they do that not just for the cities, but for the city's extraterritorial jurisdiction, which is 380 square miles. It's a really large area that we manage development for. When the development industry was hot, it was be $3.5 billion worth a year. Was not unusual.
Really?
There's a lot of activity in this county. Now it's down a lot with the economy being down as it is. Of course, we're running about 40% of that right now.
So Land Development, they give out permits to all of the buildings that are being built in the city?
Not all buildings.
Okay.
They wouldn't do a house permit.
Okay.
They would do a place that would have a commercial building.
Uh-huh.
We would do the subdivision review. If a subdivision was in for review, we'd look at the streets and drainage and that sort of stuff. But we really are in the business of the physical infrastructure that surrounds buildings. It's really the business that engineering is in. Building standards, which is a county agency, would handle
the
building requirements, the electrical, mechanical, those sorts of things, the things that are inside the building. And then we have a stormwater program, and they manage they're responsible for water quality in the city. We are responsible for the drainage system. A lot of the drainage system we take care of, both in the streets, and we do a lot of repairs on private property. Also, we are real involved. The county does a lot of the legwork on, but the city of Charlotte is the overall agency on floodways, but the county does the work on that, and they do splendid work. I think that's a great example of city-county cooperation, but that way the floodways, which are the really big named streams like McMullen or Sugar, those are managed, whether it's in the city limits or not, managed as a single stream. So those are really, the big creeks are managed by the county.
Okay.
And then engineering services does what you might think a lot of typical public works projects would be, roads, bridges, community projects, sidewalks, neighborhoods, business type projects, those sorts of things. They design and build those projects. And let's see here, who have I not named here? Business services does a lot of the support work that I mentioned earlier, helping people get their work done. So that would be everything from IT, computers to support the engineers and other staff, to HR issues, human relations, hiring, those kind of processes, pay, those kinds of, and they also handle the safety program for the department and contracting, which we do a pretty large volume of contracting. We've got a capital program that's in the hundreds of millions of dollars.
Really?
And so it gets big fast. I think this summer we're going to have $120 million worth of roads in construction.
$120 million?
In construction, and we've got a lot of other roads that are in planning or design, and the Hall of Fame is $160 million by itself. And so and we're also doing the study that just was initiated on the streetcar project.
And so
that's early planning, but that project is, $400 million plus project. So we between planning, design, construction, there are many hundreds of millions of dollars worth of projects in capital. And so the contract section of business services helps us. They manage the contract procurement process. And then real estate buys and sells and manages our real estate. Some years we might buy several thousand parcels of land because our real estate section doesn't buy the land for the airport, but any other city agency, they manage real estate purchases. And so not just our capital program, but the utility departments, water lines and sewer lines. And so if you figure there are 2,000 work hours in a year, if we buy a couple thousand parcels of land, that's about a piece of land every hour, which to me is mind-boggling. And they also handle city lease type situations, a large number of those. For example, water towers and so forth. Rather than have cell towers all everywhere for the cell phones people like to use, we try to get as many of those as we can on water towers. And so, one, that generates revenue for the city. We have about $700,000 worth of lease income from, and so the cell phone folks can save the money of building a tower. The community doesn't have a tower in it, and the city gets revenue from that. So they would manage a lot of lease type situations. And let's see here, who have I not talked about? I think that's everybody.
Yes, you've given us a pretty good overview of what all your department does, but let's break it down. Let's go to your engineering services department, since it's engineering and property management.
Yes.
What exactly do they do?
Well, they have a lot of programs they administer, and I don't know if I I'll go through these as much as I think I'll remember most of them. They do road projects, of course, and some of those roads are local roads. We also do some work on state roads. Those roads are state responsibility, but a lot of times the largest roads and the ones that are most local concern would be on a state road. And so we have a group that does state road projects. For example, a large project that we're getting ready to start is the Weave up there at 2949, which is a really challenging traffic situation today. And that one will be a really tough project due to construction under, because, of course, you can't close it when you do construction.
This is true.
So it'll be, that will be a lot of, that'll be a challenging traffic situation to have that many cars coming through there while it's under construction. It'll be hard for the traveling public, of course, while we're making those improvements. In the long run, we'll be much better off for it, but we're getting ready to start a couple of years of challenging construction up there. So that would be an example of a state project. We also do a lot of work on city streets. Most of the streets in the city are city streets. The state ones would be numbered routes like 49, 29, 74. If it's a non-numbered street, then it would be a city street. And
when you say city streets, are you meaning you repair them when there's a pothole or something like that in the street?
We don't really do pothole repairs. That would be street maintenance. What we would do is we would say that this street needs some extra lanes added to it. We just recently reconfigured all the roads around the Hall of Fame. It was a fairly large project. And so we were widening Caldwell Street and working on Brevard. And we also worked on some ramps on 277. So there was a little bit of a state aspect to that. But a lot of those were city streets, most of the streets involved in that. And engineering services also would do a neighborhood project where we might go into a neighborhood and a lot of those neighborhoods really need some public investment in them. The infrastructure's in poor shape, sidewalks, curb and gutter, the streets, the drainage. And so we have a series of public meetings with the neighborhoods and say, what would you like done here? And there are always neighborhood priorities, and we work with them to line those priorities with city goals, and then we make those improvements.
Oh, so you let the people in the community know what you're coming to do. And, do you get feedback from them as to what they want?
Yes, absolutely. Done? On neighborhood projects, the neighborhood has a lot of influence on what projects in their neighborhood we do. We certainly, there are city priorities that we want to work on, but there's a lot of latitude within those to do the parts of the project that the community is most interested in seeing done.
How do you inform the people that you're going to have a public meeting?
Well, we have huge mailing lists, and we send a lot of mailers out. We send thousands and thousands of mailers every month, because in addition to doing mailers to announce public meetings and that sort of thing, we also do periodic mailers on most all of our projects, just to let people who are in the area know what's going on, because we might have a public meeting and find out what improvements, or several public meetings to determine what improvements we're going to do in the neighborhood project, but then we have to go back and work on design for a while. And so when we're gone for several months, we send them notes and say, here's where we are, and here's when the next time we'd be contacting and that sort of stuff, so that they can stay connected to the project and know when we're likely to be out there to start construction. And as we go through construction, here are the streets we'll be working on, or if we're in the design, we might send a note out that says surveyors are going to be in the neighborhood the next few weeks, just so they won't be surprised when somebody shows up in their backyard with a survey instrument.
So you have a surveying section also?
Yes, I didn't mention that in real estate. We have an in-house survey group in real estate. Though I would say one of the philosophies that's been a real guiding philosophy for the engineering and property management department is that we contract most activities, including survey, including real estate acquisition. We do some acquisitions in-house, we do some survey in-house, we do some design in-house, but the vast majority of those are done through contracts. We hire consultants on survey and on design. We have contractors for most of our real estate acquisitions. We have always tried to staff way below what our workload is, which is not a lot of public works agencies have a lot of crews and do a lot of work in-house. We hire consultants for most of our work.
Oh, well, that's a good thing. You're giving the people in our community a chance to do some work for the city, too.
Yes, it does provide that opportunity, for sure. And also, our work tends to be sort of surgy, because the voters will approve a bond referendum. November a year ago, they approved it was the biggest bond referendum in the city's history. So there's a big surge of work there. But over a couple of years, that all gets done. And of course, our staff load, we don't want to raise and lower our staff level with that kind of work. And so if you hire a lot of consultants, then it it gets the projects underway right away without waiting for hiring and all the training and all those kinds of things. It provides a great opportunity for the private sector. And then as the work gets finished, then you don't have folks that you don't have work for. And so it really lets you tailor the size of your staff to the size of your workload.
You had mentioned earlier that we manage and maintain several city buildings. Did we design those buildings?
In many cases, we did.
Oh, we did?
Yes.
What are some of the buildings that we've designed?
Well, by designed, we hired consultants to design.
Oh, sorry.
Yes, we don't. We have a small group that does in-house design for roadway and that sort of projects, but we don't have any building designers in-house. We hire architecture firms for all that, and so, for example, the Uptown Arena, Ellerby Beckett was the architect. They're nationally known. They're actually worldwide. Architecture firm that does arenas and sports facilities all over the world, the Hall of Fame is Paycob Fried, which is IMPAY, I think would be one of the top names in architecture really in the world. It's a very prestigious firm. And we have lots of local firms. Those two firms were not local, but the city has a very strong bias and a strong policy for hiring local firms. If the expertise can be acquired locally, we will use local firms. Mm-hmm. And so there aren't nationally known firms that do arenas, for example, in Charlotte. But on fire stations, that sort of stuff, we would not ever look outside of our community for architects to do that kind of work. We've got some great local firms. Uh-huh. Charlotte is really blessed with engineering and architecture firms. We have, I think, several times more than Atlanta does, for example. We have a lot of firms that do work in that area, so we've got a great deal of talent in that area.
So did you have consultants help you with the design and the managing the projects for fire stations or the police department? Do you have a special section in engineering that takes care of those types of buildings?
Yes, within buildings and grounds, there is special projects, and they manage the construction of building projects, which would be, all those kinds of projects. That was the group I was in when we did the government center.
Oh, really?
Yes. Yeah, long ago. In 1985, we started that project, finished it in the 80s. So
you did that?
Yes. Mm. I was project manager for that project.
You did a good job. The building is still there.
It is. And has recently won a couple of significant awards.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was recently selected as an Energy Star facility, which means based on its energy use per square foot, it's one of the very highest performing buildings around. There are only four in Uptown Charlotte that qualified as Energy Star.
Huh.
And so that's really good, especially for a building that's 20 years old. And then last week we received news that it was selected as a BOMA 360 building. And there are about 20 criteria requirements for that, but one is being Energy Star. And I think in the southern United States there are only three. Two others that are in Charlotte. There's one that's, I think, in Atlanta, and now there's a fourth one. The government center was selected. That's looking at overall building management, how well managed the building is. We have a lot of, as I mentioned earlier, a lot of great employees, and in our buildings area, both the folks that build our buildings, I think, do a really wonderful job, and the folks who are managing them are just doing a splendid job. In fact, the Green Building Public Leader of the Year Award, the last two, went to building standards, building management folks. Steve Marlowe does our roof program, and David Miller does our building energy efficiency.
Let's talk a little bit more about land development. You gave us a short couple of sentences about them. I'm sure they do a lot more than that. Can you share that with us?
Well, we in that group we have folks that do urban forestry. They administer the tree ordinance, which is one of our most enjoyable ordinances. Charlotte loves its trees.
Yes, we do.
And so we have a tree ordinance that is very protective of trees. I think the development community probably thinks we protect trees too much, and folks who are near where we're developing probably think we don't protect them enough. We usually say if on the regulatory side there's concern on both sides, we're probably in the right balance point. And so they the that we have a the the tree ordinance protects trees through the development process. We've got engineers who review drainage drainage and erosion control type requirements are also reviewed there. Not by the engineers. We have an erosion control group there that looks at erosion control plans. We have some folks that review driveways there, and we have some folks that review the zoning requirements, setbacks and that sort of stuff.
Your construction program, that's a part of your engineering services, correct?
We have construction inspectors in two major areas. One is the stormwater program. We have a lot of inspectors there, and we also have inspectors in engineering services, as you mentioned.
And what exactly do they do?
Our construction inspectors in those two sections, what they do is they work with the contractor to make sure that work is built according to the plans and specifications that were required by the engineer, the design engineer. And they also work with the contractor on things. There's no set of plans that's ever been done that has been perfect that I'm aware of. And so there are almost always some field changes that have to be dealt with. And so they deal with the contractor on those. Often they're citizen concerns. We've had inspectors who have rearranged projects because somebody had a wedding and they needed to be able to park along the street, or all kinds of things happen in the field that need to be addressed. And so they deal with access issues and communicate with the neighbors about what's happening and when. Coordinate with them on driveway closures, for example. If we're repouring a driveway for them, then we would have to close their driveway for a while we work there. They also do the measure up of quantities, which is the basis for paying the contractor. Each month they will go out and say, well, this is how many total feet of curb and gutter and this many feet of this. They measure the job each month, and then based on that measurement, the contractor's paid based on work in place that's been accepted.
You know, when we talked about a little bit about real estate, let's talk about them some more. I didn't realize that the city actually bought land or property or sold it. I just thought we just got it if we needed it.
Well, that's true too. We do that.
Let's talk about some more things that they do in real estate.
Well, let's see here. In addition to buying and selling real estate and managing sort of the leases and so forth for cell towers and survey, I think that's pretty much the gist of it. They work on a wide range of types of projects, certainly with those types of activities that they could run everywhere from an economic development project to a Charlotte-Mecklenburg utilities project to a neighborhood or sidewalk or a street, or looking for a site for a new police station. We're looking for that right now, a new, not a main police station, but we're setting up some district stations. That's the kind of, they might be acquiring property for a lot of different purposes, but.
So you just mentioned that they're looking for property for like one of those substations for the police department. What exactly happens whenever the city decides we're going to build this police station in XYZ neighborhood? What's the steps? Could you walk us through that?
Well, we work with the client department. One thing to remember with the engineering department is other than the stormwater program, we're really providing services to the citizens through a client department. When we're building a police station, we're building it for, the police department or for the fire department, if it's the fire department. And so we would talk with them about what their goals were, what their criteria was. And Chief Monroe is, we have had police stations located rental property in various places. Like they would be in a mall, and lots of them are still in those kinds of locations. Chief Monroe is interested in raising the profile of the police department, and that's one of his strategic plans that he has worked with the council on and so forth. And so they are trying to build police stations in high-profile locations where they think they can really have a big impact. And the Metro Police Station was a key to that. So it's on Beatty's Ford Road. It's put in a location where the neighborhoods there really are glad to have it there. They feel like it's an important asset to their community and creates a new partnership relation with the police, but it's also in a high visibility location instead of being some square footage inside of a mall where you might not know it was there. It's right there on the main street, up close to the street, big sign. It's creating a sense of police presence in that community. And so the police would have criteria such as that. And then based on that, they have a number of acres they need, an amount of parking. We would look for sites that met those criteria and then confer with the police department as our client and agree on a site. Then, of course, the land some places cost a lot more than others, so there are budget questions. And so the process would sort of be hand in hand with the police department on figuring out where we're going to locate it.
Uh-huh. Tell us before we close, Jeb, what are some of your challenges being the city engineer?
I think I may have about the best job in the world. I love my job.
Okay.
I get to work on a lot of great projects with a lot of great people, and I think we have as a city council that is really committed to the community and works together well. I know that they sometimes disagree and knock heads, but I think it's with the best motives. Uh-huh. They really are arguing for what they believe is best for the community. Uh-huh. And I think you could see that in that campaign we just had with Lasseter and Fox. And so, but you have to work through what the values of the community are. That's a big challenge. The council tells you what the values are. Our job is to implement that in a way that high level of citizen service in a really efficient and effective way. And and of course, money's always, there's never as much money as you'd like to have. So you're
never
trying to
enough money.
Do as much as you can with what you have. And again, the blessing we have, the great thing is we have so many great employees. That's why I've stayed with this department. When I started here, I didn't know I'd be here for a career.
Really?
But it is such a great place to work, such a great bunch of people.
What is one thing that you would like to change, if anything?
I would like to change.
Yes.
I would love it if I could get through information faster. There's always more emails and more meetings, more stuff that I just feel like if I could get through more of that, I could I could do a better job with my job. Uh-huh. And it's always trying to be the best that you can be is the challenge.
It sounds like you have a good team working for you too.
They are great. I think both with my family and with my my coworkers, I got better than I deserved. I'm not sure how.
Well, Jeb, thank you so much for joining us. You know, I really think we could talk another 30 minutes about what you do for the city and all the things you do. We did touch on a few things, but if you would like more information about what exactly is engineering and property management, you can visit my website at www.abetteryoushow.com, or you could go to the city's website, www.charmette.org, and they have a lot of information there about engineering and property management and the services that they provide for the citizens in the city of Charlotte. Thank you. That's my show.
My pleasure. It's my pleasure.
Thank you for joining me, Jeb.
Sure, my pleasure.